You know that look, the look people give that says you're not good enough? It's like you're lacking something, something that everybody else seems to have. And when a lot of people give you that look, you start believing that you actually are not good enough. Maybe it happened with you, happened with me too. Right from the start, when I was just a little kid, people used to tell me, you shouldn't be so shy, you should talk more, you should express more, you should be this, you should be that. And when you are a kid, you believe what people say. So I started believing that I was this good-for-nothing piece of crap who had nothing but flaws. Maybe those people were trying to help me, but the way I was constantly made aware of my shortcomings, it only made me more and more conscious of them. And I developed this fear that if I won't be able to overcome my defects, I'll be a failure in life. But you know how fear never results in anything good. So it only made me more anxious and a creep. But as I grew up, I started getting fed up with all those inputs people were giving me. And at one point I said to myself, what if I don't do what people want me to do? What's the worst that can happen? People won't like me. They don't like me anyways. They keep finding faults in me. So to hell with everything. And then I decided to stop caring about other people's views. And when I stopped caring, I noticed that I was able to overcome my shortcomings without much work. Because then I wasn't driven by fear. I was driven by self-assurance. And that came from accepting myself the way I was. And I realized that if those people had also accepted me the way I was, my shortcomings wouldn't have debilitated me for so long. And I would have focused more on my strengths than focusing on what I lacked all the time. So this video is for every kid or grown-up who's going through something similar as me. Just remember that you have both strengths and weaknesses, just like everybody else. But don't let others decide what's your strength and what's your weakness. Because it's your life, you know what works for you. If being an antisocial gives you the time to think, imagine, and create new things, then don't listen to those who say being antisocial is bad. People will keep saying things that will never stop. It's up to you what you want to pay attention to and what you don't want to pay attention to. Don't let others play with your mind and hamper your mental peace. Do what's best for you and be your own guiding light. And then you'll realize your true worth and what a special person you are.